So now that I've created these categories, I'm going to go into the elements themselves and go ahead and assign these to these individual elements to categories. I think I'll just do it like this. Production line 1, we'll call that front end. Now don't do this under the attributes. Each individual attribute can have categories. I haven't defined any categories for attributes though. This is on the element level. So on the element level, I'm going to call this front end. This is production line 1. And I'll do the same thing here for this storage tank. You notice this is not available. The reason this is not available is because this is an element that is based on a template that is not extensible. So let's go ahead and remedy this by going out to the storage tank template and making it extensible. I'll go into the storage tank template. Yeah, it is not set to allow extensions. Go ahead and set that, check it in. And now if we go back to that storage tank, yeah, here we go. You notice this is front end. I'm going to go ahead and make this front end as well. And now that's available to us. As you can see, something can belong to more than one category. In this case, I really don't have something to demonstrate there. This is going to be back end. These mixing tank 2 here. There we go. And I'll check this all in. And the big finish, of course, is now that my search is something that is beyond what I can do, just simply using those element templates. So instead of being restricted just to element templates, let's go up to the top of the hierarchy here. Instead of just being restricted to the element templates, I can specify certain categories. I'll do a search for backend. And there we go. Here's what we found. These mixing tank and storage tank 2. Switch this around to front end, we'll find the others.